the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please be seated. Your Grace, our dear Father and our dear Archbishop, our brother priests who are here with us, the married brothers, our female religious who are here with us, our catechists, our candidates for the sacrament, our dear brothers and sisters, good morning to you all.
Good morning.
All of us will agree that today is indeed a day the Lord has made for us, and the Lord has given us cause for joy, as we gladly, very delightfully welcome and receive our dear Archbishop and Chief Shepherd, Most Reverend Dr. Ignatius Kaigama, to our parish, St. Anthony's Parish, Yangoji. We all know, please put your hands together. We're very happy to receive the Archbishop with us physically in our church, and he has always expressed his heartfelt love, his concern, and indeed his care for our parish community, knowing that what we have gone through in the last couple of years. We thank God that with his prayers, with his blessings, and also with our prayers and devotion, our strong faith in God, peace have come back to our community. And indeed, we have the fruits of the work of evangelization in the 78 candidates we have this morning for the sacrament of confirmation. To receive you, we are deeply appreciative of your love, your concern for us. And shortly, early in the year, I received the package from you for our community, especially to those in the remote areas, the indigent community of our parishioners who are unable to return back to their farms because of the insecurity. We received it happily and delightfully. It is our prayer that God and through your leadership continue to take our archdiocese to greater heights, to the glory of his holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
By grace you are most welcome.
Let us stand and continue the Holy Mass. Thank you, Father Nicholas Kaigama, for the words of welcome. And I'm happy to see you again after a long time. Our task this morning is to pray, to talk to God our Father about you, about us, about our needs. So in faith and trust, let us prepare ourselves to celebrate this Holy Mass. Now we know that a lot of good things will come to us if we celebrate bodily. So before we go on, let us call to mind our sins and ask God, our Father, full of mercy, to forgive us. I confess to Almighty God, graciously on this confession of our lowliness, that we who are bowed down by our conscience may always be lifted up by your mercy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, God spoke all these words, saying, I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourselves a graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. You shall not bow down to them or serve them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children, the third and the fourth generation of those who hate me, and showing mercy to thousands of those who love me and keep my commandments. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. For the Lord will not hold him guiltless who takes his name in vain. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. You shall not do any work, you, your son, your daughter, your manservant, or your maidservant, or your cattle, or the sojourner who is within your gates. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea and all that is in them, and rested the seventh day. Therefore, the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. Honor your father and your mother, that your days may be long in the land which the Lord your God gives you. You shall not kill. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife, or his manservant, or his maidservant, or his ox, or his donkey, or anything that is your neighbor's. The word of the Lord.
Eternal life.
Lord, you have the words of eternal life. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, Jews demand signs and Greeks seek wisdom, but we preach Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and falling to Gentiles, but to those who are called, both Jews and Greek, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. For the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men. The words of the Lord.
The Passover of the Jews was at hand, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. In the temple, he found those who were selling oxen and sheep and pigeons, and the money changers at their business. And making a whip out of cords, he drove them all with the sheep and oxen out of the temple. And he poured out the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. And he told those who sold the pigeons, "Take these things away. You shall not make my father's house a house of trade." His disciples remembered that it was written, "Zeal for your house will consume me." The Jews then said to him, "What sign have you to show us for doing this?" Jesus answered them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." The Jews then said, "It has taken 46 years to build this temple, and you will raise it up in 3 days?" But he spoke of the temple of his body. When therefore he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they believed the scripture and the word which Jesus had spoken. Now, when he was in Jerusalem at the Passover feast, many believed in his name when they saw the signs which he did. But Jesus did not trust himself to them, because he knew all men and needed no one to bear witness of men, for he himself knew what was in man. The Gospel of the Lord.
Peace be with you all.
And with
your spirit. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
You dear parishioners of St. Anthony's Parish, Yangoji. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
I'm happy to be with you. And I can see so many of you assembled, the different groups that make up the family of this parish. I know that you have suffered a lot in different ways, but I'm still happy to see you. I think this is my very first visit. Is that so?
Yes.
I have visited here with Father Clement yesterday. And that was when your parish priest, who was kidnapped, had gone away. We thank God that he came back alive. We pray that these kind of things will not happen again. And we know that God hears our prayers and will not allow evil things to happen to us. I am so happy to see you still shining despite all the challenges and the difficulties. The catkids are there at their work. You can see them. The children are there behind them. They are the hope. They are the future of this church. Those children you are seeing there, tomorrow they will be the chairman of this, chairwoman of that. So we have trust and we hope that God will raise them up in accordance with his will. Then we have the different groups, beginning with the wonderful choir, the singing typical Yangoji songs. And we are happy with that, and I'm sure they will give us beautiful songs for our liturgy to flow smoothly. Then, of course, there's Muntamata. They met me at the gate there. They are always alive. They are so dynamic. I call them ever ready, because they are always ever ready to perform. In the daytime or nighttime, the women are always ready. They see CWO, I am sure you are here. You are doing the same. The CMO, are you here? And CYO, are you here? Very good. So everybody has a place in the church, and everybody, because of your baptismal dignity and honor, you have a place, you have a task. I see the students. These are students of where? Where? Dominican College. Wow, we have the students from the Dominican College. It's wonderful. It's nice to have you. Then we have the brothers, the Maris brothers, who are here also. They have a college. So it's good to see all of you together and to know that your faith continues to grow, to work stronger, despite all the challenges that are posed to us. Our prayer is that you will continue to be people of faith. You will be people of hope, determined. chapter 8, verses 38 to 39. The first reading today tells us about the 10 commandments given by God. There are 10 commandments. I see here we have the candidates for confirmation. Father tells me there are 78 of you, and you have come from different locations so as to receive confirmation. And confirmation means you are now adults in the faith, you are mature, you are strong, you are ambassadors, you are witnesses, you are going to represent Christ wherever you find yourself. And which means you must know your faith. You must know your faith. I hope you know your faith very well, that you can stand up and talk about your faith without fear, without shame. Some people are ashamed or afraid to talk about their faith. Once you are confirmed, you have been stamped with the seal of the Holy Spirit, so you can stand boldly and talk about your faith without fear, without shame. We hear about the Ten Commandments today, and I am sure you candidates of confirmation, you are aware of the Ten Commandments. How many commandments are we? Ten. Do you know them? Please, can you recite them? One, go on.
Defiling the sanctuary, and they were not doing honor to the place where God resides. And we are told today it's not just the physical church. I can see your church has improved even since the last time I came. The last time I came, you didn't have the tiles. You didn't have even the ceiling. I'm sure you had it, but not like this. And many other things. So you have done so well. You can see things are improving by the grace of God. Little by little, eh? Little by little, we shall get there. And I know your ceiling is good, but if I stretch my hand like that, I can almost touch it. That means there is work to do more. There will come a time when you will have a church that will be standard. Even if I double myself, I will not touch the ceiling. But now, my staff here, if I just raise it like this, it will touch the ceiling. But I'm happy you have done something. You have done some work. And then we say slow and steady. You are going slow and steady despite all the challenges. So keep it up. That is what I have come here to tell you. Keep it up. And today I told you Jesus got angry just because people were turning the house of God into a place of commerce. And Jesus is whipping them and driving them away. That shows that God can be loving, but God can also be angry. If you commit sin, you do bad things, you make God angry. But God is Father. He is loving. He is merciful. Jesus driving away these people today shows that God can be angry when we do certain things. So let us not take God for granted and just say, no, he's our Father. Oh, he's merciful. He's all forgiving. So we do anything and behave as we like. No, you must do the will of God, not your own will. You must do the will of God. So Jesus tells us to be correct and do the right thing. And you also know that the cross for us Christians is the center of our faith. Even in this church, the cross is the center. Everything we do rotates around the cross. On the cross, Jesus died for us. And that is what we celebrate. That is what we remember. For the Jews and the Gentiles, it is stumbling block. It is foolishness. But for us, it is salvation. Some people cannot understand how Jesus will die on the cross and we say he is saving us. They can't understand. But for us, we believe that was God's will, that he should come and he should die on the cross for us. So we should reverence the cross. We should respect the cross. And when things are tough for you, when things are not going well for you, look at the cross. Like those difficult times when some of you were attacked or even killed, and then you were afraid to come to church, you were afraid to go out to anywhere, you know, you were suffering. But we are asked to look at the cross, because Jesus has done it all for us. So the cross is sacred, and we should honor it. And even the church, as you are gathered here, this place has become a holy ground. It may not be as beautiful as the cathedral in the city, but it is a place of prayer. We believe that God is dwelling here. And God loves you even as you are. So you should respect this place. This is a church. So you cannot do anything anyhow. You cannot be sitting in this church and playing. In fact, for us Catholics, if you are passing a church building, even outside, the moment you pass the church, you make the sign of the cross to show that this is a holy place. So you make the sign of the cross to show that you honor this place and you respect it. So today we are asked to make sure we give honor to God when we come to worship like this together. Let it not just be like we have come to a theater where there's a lot of plays and actors are making different kind of plays and so on. No, this is a place to come and pray. This is a place to reconcile. This is a place to bring us together. We are from different ethnic groups. We have different people here. The Igbos are here. The Tiv are here. The Gala are here. The Yoruba are here. All of us come from different places. Even today, we are lucky we have some people outside of the country. They are French people. They are French. That is their ethnic identity. They are French. I'm talking about Samuel and Vodouin. Samuel, can you stand, let them see? This is his son, Kaigama. He is there. So you can see how beautiful our Catholic faith is. They came all the way from France, and this is their first time, is it? The first time in Nigeria. But today they are in Yangoji.
Sometimes you wonder whether they are pastors from God
way they talk and what they say is as if they are taking away people from the path of salvation. These pastors focus only on prosperity, and miracles. They just talk about prosperity and miracles. And some of them, I would say, are not even pastors called by God. They are mere motivational speakers. You know motivational speakers? People who encourage you to do this and you will get this. If you do this, you will be rich. If you do this, you will be strong. They are motivational speakers rather than men or women of God. They are abusing that sacred institution of the church by making the church into a place of business, into a place of commerce. Some are behaving as if the church is a company they have established. The father establishes the company, and when he is old, he hands over to the son, and the son hands over to the other, like a thing of inheritance. But that is not how the church should be. So we should talk to ourselves too. And many pastors inspire division, hatred among the people. A pastor will tell you that he is a prophet, he is a seer, he can see visions, and he will tell you, oh, I see, your uncle is trying to poison you. Your wife is going to kill you so that she can inherit all your property. A pastor will say, this is a vision, this is prophecy. And then you will set fire in your house. Before you know it, the husband and the wife are fighting. The family is no longer together. People are afraid of one another because the pastor has put division into them. So these kind of pastors should be very careful. So we ask everybody to look inwards. This is the period of Lent. Everybody that is doing something that is not good, stop it. Anything that you are doing that is not good, you know it better. I don't know what is in your heart. You don't know what is in my heart. So all the things that we do that are not good, Lent calls us to stop them. And also we hope those who are doing evil things, right now we are here, there are some people who are stuck in the bush. There are some people who are kidnapped and they are with the kidnappers in the bush. So we are praying during this Lenten season that God will touch the hearts of these kidnappers. That God will touch them and change them and transform them. Just as we are praying that God will transform us. We must all do the right thing so that God will be happy with us. So we ask God to help us, to remove the heart of bitterness and evil. Imagine somebody who is a preacher, a religious leader, saying publicly to everybody that they should kill this woman. They should kill this woman. I've heard it. I've seen it. I don't know how true that is. But if it is true that an Islamic religious leader will come out and pronounce that they should kill the wife of the president of Nigeria, it is very, very sad. What kind of religion is that? Your neighbor offends you and all you think about is to kill. You don't think about reconciliation. You don't think about peaceful and amicable settlement. Yet we have so many of these people. They are preaching hatred, preaching death and destruction. And what amazes me is that nothing happens to them. Like this man who claimed to be a religious preacher, Islamic religious preacher, who says they should kill a human being, the wife of the president of the country, and then nothing is done. Before you know it, this is forgotten. This is not good. Such people should be fished out, should be identified. Why do they hate humanity? So our government should do something. All I can say during this period as I conclude is, Lord have mercy on us. Can you repeat that?
Lord have mercy.
Again.
Lord have mercy.
Again.
Lord have mercy.
And I pray that this season of Lent will transform our lives, will transform our lives as Christians, will even transform our country, Nigeria. And will transform the lives of those who are doing evil, those who are in the bush committing all kinds of atrocities or criminal activities, and those who are in the government who are denying the poor the resources that are due to them. God will touch their lives and change them, all of them and all of us. And all this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord.
to Jesus. So we shall now have the rite of confirmation. So those to be confirmed, you will stand on your seat, and the prayers will go. At the end of the prayers and the blessing, then you will come forward to the sanctuary as though you do during Holy Communion. And that is when you will be anointed. You have your individual sponsors, we are aware. But at this time, we require four adults representing the remaining sponsors to come forward. Four of them. Those to be confirmed, you have candles with you. You shall not use them now. During the prayers of the faithful, your candles will be lighted, and that is when you will use them.
Okay, we shall begin the rite of confirmation. So, may I invite the candidates for confirmation to please come. And we begin by asking you to renew your baptismal promises. And after which, we shall renew our profession of faith, which means that the choir will not sing the creed, because we shall renew it in a shortened format. Everybody will join us to do so. So, but for now, to the candidates for confirmation, I ask you the question, do you reject Satan and all his works and all his empty promises? Good. Satan is like a roaring lion, going around looking for people to devour. So I'm happy you have said you will resist him, you will resist her. Satan is both a man and a woman, is it? You don't know. So we have to resist the devil anyway. That is what you have just professed. So now we will all stand. The congregation, all inside, you stand, and you will, along with the candidates, answer the questions I am going to pose about our faith. So, to all of you now, do you believe in the God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who came upon the apostles at Pentecost and today is given to you sacramentally in confirmation?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith, and this is the faith of the church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Congregation, you can sit down. While those to be confirmed, you kneel down to receive this prayer. The priests and I will extend our hands over you to ask God to pour his gifts of the Holy Spirit upon you to make you strong and good soldiers of Jesus Christ. All-powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, you freed your sons and daughters from sin and gave them new life. your Holy Spirit upon them to be their helper and guide. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of right judgment and courage, the spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with the spirit of wonder and awe in your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Good. Now we have prayed for you. We are going to confirm you with Holy Chrism. You will start coming from the back, and then you will line up as if you are coming for Holy Communion. Father Nicholas Ekenan will help me in anointing some of you. I will anoint some of you, he does the rest. So whatever he does is the bishop doing it, and regard yourself as confirmed with the chrism of salvation. So you line up properly in an orderly manner, and then only four people will represent the sponsors. Every one of you must have a sponsor. A sponsor is one who accompanies you, who helps you spiritually and directs you and guides you. He's a friend, a companion. That is who a sponsor should be. Thank you. the church that through her ministry, Christians may rediscover their true identity as members of Christ's body and participate with greater enthusiasm in the proclamation of the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Thank you. With the blessed apostles, with Saint Anthony of Padua, and all the
unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Prayer for help.
Lord, have peace with you.
Gracias.
the Igbo Catholic community will be the third group to come. Lastly, it's going to be the Zumunta Mata and Mummies. Thank you.
All glory to Jesus. Our Lord is good. St. Anthony's family. Before the Thanksgivings begin, our little expression of our happiness and our excitement today for what God has done for us, I beg to take a few minutes to say a few words adding to what our dear PPC Vice Chairman has already said. Your Grace, we are very happy, as you can see us today. And your visit today is a very solid and a very concrete expression of your fatherly love and concern for this parish and our community, and it is something that our people know very, very well. And that is why they have traveled all around our stations, with all our stations within our parish territory. Some of them are coming from places, interior villages, 2 hours to the express for them to be here. Some of them were here since on Friday and have refused to go back just to witness this occasion, because it will be difficult for them to come out on a regular Sunday to meet the mass here at 10. And some of them with the villages called Fobe, Leda, Yebu, Kibe, have been to many of them. And I have seen the people as they are, and I can appreciate the depth of sacrifice it takes for them to be here. These are the people who have filled this church today to welcome your Grace. And we are very happy, not minding the difficulty, but we are happy in faith that our Father has come to us, and we are very glad to receive you. Your Grace, this is short of a miracle. This is a miracle. This is a blessing for our community. And may the Lord continue to preserve you and bless you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We also want to recognize and welcome certain very special people who are here with us. Here with us is the Esu of Yangoji community present with us. Please, Esu, we are very happy to have you. Immediately, we informed him of your coming, Your Grace. He ensured and cancelled several appointments, making sure that you'll be here to receive you in our community and in our parish. I have some chiefs who are also here with him, and we are very grateful that 2 of our eminent parishioners are chiefs in his council. We have Chief Augustine Ugoji sitting next to him. Please. We also have Chief John Bancom sitting somewhere in the congregation. He's also a leader of the community in his cabinet. And he has shown us great love and assisted us many a time. So we have occasions, he makes himself available and he worships with us. And so we are very happy to have you with us. We also have within us here the Maris brothers who are here with us from the school, Maris College, Yangoji. They are always our sister community. They are here with us. Please put your hands together for them. And Brother Stephen and Brother with us. I also want to thank in a very special way Father Moses Rowe with his brother Michael, the principal of St. Dominican College, down there in Anene, close to Bali, who are here with us. We want to thank you. They also brought some of their students who they have prepared for the sacrament. They are among those who have received the sacrament, who have been confirmed today. And in our midst too, we want to welcome our dear brother, his son, and the associate, Mr. Samuel, all the way from Paris, all the way from France, who have come to pay us a visit. Please, could you stand up for recognition? As I interacted with him, he told me why he came. He said he wanted to have a first-hand experience of our travail in this area, and that he wanted to also come to know the feelings, how we are coping with the situation, the trauma, and at the same time experience the depth of our faith, that in spite of the challenges we have had, we are moving on, we are pushing. And I did tell him, you will see it in the people. You will see our pain and our suffering, but you will also see the effects of God's grace in our midst. And we are very happy to have you with us. Thank you very much, Mr. Sammy, your son, Bodo, and our sister. And we have so many people here who have prepared to ensure that we have a very beautiful day today. I want to thank the members of the Zumunta, our mama, our Lisfidi, a little house, you know, Allah Samuk and Baraka.
Amen.
Yes, thank you so much for being here. They graciously welcome the Archbishop. Not forgetting, I also have female religious, our reverend sisters who are here with us, two Dominican sisters, one Immaculate Heart sister. I hope I'm correct. Thank you so much, sisters, for coming. Please kindly stand up for recognition. All right. I've been told that yet another sister is here with us. Sorry, sister, I didn't see you early enough. Could you stand up for recognition? God bless you, sister. Yes, Christiana. Thank you very much. God bless you, sister. Our catechists all around our stations, the areas where I cannot easily get to, our catechists are there leading the people, teaching them the faith and leading them in worship. They have all gathered here to be with us. Our catechists, thank you so much for the good work you do. Kindly stand up for recognition. Please put your hands together for them. Thank you very much, our dear catechists, our mass servants, our church warden, our lectors, everybody. All hands have been on deck to prepare for this day. Our church warden and the station council, also doubling as the organizing committee, we want to thank you. And I want to sincerely, from the depths of my heart, thank everybody, all men, women, and children. Everybody came out to prepare for this day. And we can all testify that we are all sharing in the joy of what the Lord has done for us. We pray that the blessing of God will remain abundant with us, and we always have cause to give God glory and thanksgiving through Christ our Lord.
Yeah.
Yes, as our BBC Vice Chairman has rightly said, we have tried as our community to move on. We are people who are rich in faith. I say that anywhere, but we are simple of means. Whenever a need arises where we need to do something, you can see the passion, the drive in the part of the people to be part of the progress of the parish. Only that our means are simple. And this is also why our people outside, other Catholics, friends, who are very concerned and empathic with us, have also lent in their support to help us to reach where we are. As you rightly said, a lot of work needs to be done. And as the Archbishop also noticed, we still have a lot. And so we are using this opportunity to plead with him in his fatherly heart, to look at our community, to look at our church, to look at our parishes. And however the Archdiocese can help us, we will be deeply grateful. We will remain very indebted to you, our dear Father. But most importantly, we are very happy to see you, and we warmly welcome you. And this is our prayer that God our Father will sustain you in grace and in health, and will always be with you through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you so much, Your Grace.
Out in the order I earlier announced for the Thanksgiving. Please, let's make it snappy, please.
as we have all come, we can all indeed see that today, hey children, let's go. Jesus. Again, brothers and sisters. Some groups have come out in their small numbers and have come to receive the gracious blessings of God coming from our Father, our dear Archbishop. But I have discovered that he desires that everybody who is here will receive his fatherly blessings. And we know how to snatch blessings anywhere that God gives us. So we are all going to come up now, everybody. We are now going to come up for this special Thanksgiving, where we will receive the special blessings from our dear Father, the Archbishop. So Maya, give us something to make us dance and glorify God. And everybody will come out for this Thanksgiving. Thank you very much.
Yeah. My dear brothers and sisters, I have done this at my little address at the beginning, but it's only proper, my dear brothers and sisters, to introduce to us our wonderful friends, brothers and sisters who have joined us in today's celebrations. And I want to begin from those on the sanctuary. Sitting next to our dear Archbishop, once again, is very Reverend Father Moses Aaron. He is a principal of Dominican College, Yangoji. Please put your hands together for him. And I want to use this opportunity to thank him in a very special way. He is always one of our own and our brother. In spite of the heavy work he has to administer their nascent school that is still growing, he is always ready to make himself available to assist us pastorally whenever we are in need. We know that very well, and we have enjoyed his presence and support. Father, may God continue to bless you and grant you the grace and strength to continue your good work through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In the same vein, I will also want to introduce the assistant, Father Michael. Thank you so much for being with us. This is your first time in Yangoji Parish, and we are delighted to have you with us. You are very welcome. I have sitting next to Father Michael, my own brother and our brother. He is the priest in charge of Immaculate Heart Pastoral Area, Lambata, very close to us here, and always available to help us. Please stand up for the recognition. Let our people meet you. He has been here a couple of times.
And also, he is never ready to assist, Thank you so much.
Sitting next to him is the secretary to our dear And I have on this side, like I did before, our dear brothers, the Maris brothers of the Maris College opposite here. We also go there for mass, and whenever we have special occasions, they are always here to identify with us. We have representing the whole community, Brother Stephen and Brother Christian. Please put your hands together for them. Please put your hands together for them. Please put your hands together for them. Thank you so much, To my utmost surprise, I was very excited to meet him, Dr. Jude Unna. I don't think he's a bigger name when it comes to the political music in Nigeria. Please. Please, can you stand up for the recognition? Thank you very much. Thank you for being with us. And our friends too, who came to join us, the drummers, the instrumentalists, the organists, we are very happy to have you with us. Members of the CTV, I don't know, it is just providential. We know we may not afford for the moment what it takes to invite you, but it's our aspiration that in a good day we invite you, especially as a parish, to be with us. But you have granted us the joy of coming to televise our mass today with our dear Bishop, with our father. We are very happy with you. Thank you very, very much. We have earlier introduced and welcomed the Su of Yangoji in our community. Zaki, we are very happy to receive you. Our students from Dominican College, all our brothers and sisters coming from the outstations. There are reverend sisters amongst us here too. We're very happy to have you. Our brothers and sisters from Fobe, from Leda, from Kibwe, from Gugwa, all of our stations in the remote areas who are here, we are very happy to receive you. And now you have seen for yourself, as I keep communicating, that the Archbishop cares so much about us. He knows all that you are going through. He's always in prayer for us. He's always asking after us. And I know you completely believe now that you have seen him presently sitting with us. We thank you for every sacrifice you have made to be here. May God continue to bless you now and always through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God bless you. Thank you very much. And at this moment, we want to kindly invite our dear Bishop, who may have a few words for us.
church here. You will be in a very big parish, and your parish will divide into two or three or four even. So don't be discouraged. Don't be discouraged. Every Sunday I go to the villages, I get the same litany of complaints and issues. We don't have this, we don't have that. This is not here, this is not there. I get this every Sunday. And sometimes it as if it would discourage me. Because I say, these people don't have this, they don't have that, and I don't have to give them, it's very discouraging. But I tell myself, we depend on God's providence of God. The many places I have gone to, yours, even far, 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 far better. There are some with nothing, no house, no church, no land even. There are some places, they are to be demolished very soon, some churches. So I think we should not be discouraged. Let's take one day at a time. One day at a time. So I'm aware that you are here. I'm aware of all the problems you are going through. But please, you should also be aware that we are not government. The Archdiocese is not a government. It is the government that has all the money. They have everything. But they don't share it. It doesn't reach us. Even the little that we do for you, government does not help us. That is what you should know. So some people may think we are like the president in Abuja or Senate president or the ministers. Every month or every month, yeah, they give you your allocation, then you distribute. No, we don't get anything. The government does not support. Even though we are trying to contribute in terms of education, healthcare, look, you see our students there, you see, we are contributing little by little, but they don't come to our assistance. We are praying and begging them to come to our assistance so that we can come to your assistance. So please, let's not be discouraged. As we say, it is better to light a candle than to cause the darkness. If there is so much darkness, just light a little candle, very little candle. You will see the light and go, you see, like this. If there is darkness, everywhere is darkness. Just light this. Take this. And it will show you where to go. But if you are complaining, waiting for NEPA to come, NEPA may not come. So please, keep up the good work. That is all I can say. Where it is possible, we will intervene. But I don't assure you that we have any big thing there waiting to distribute to you. We have created over 60 pastoral areas. And we have very many parishes that are very poor, very rural. They have nothing. But I say, let us not be discouraged. Look at the faith I have seen. The wonderful expression of faith and joy and hope I have seen. Keep it up. That is all I can say. We shall continue talking with your parish priest. May God bless you. May God keep you. Those of you who are going back to the villages in the interior, may God take you safely. Amen. And may God protect you and guide you from every harm and evil. Those who are planning to do evil against you will not succeed in the name of Jesus. Yeah. God bless you. We shall continue talking. All right. So, very good. So thank you once again, Father Nicholas, the priest here, Principal Moses, all of you, Lambata, all of you, the brothers, Mary's brothers, the Katkis, our bulldozers. They are working very hard. Without them, the priest cannot succeed. So well done, and keep up the good work, please. And then you, the congregation. I greet my dear chief, Esu Yangoji, together with your staff, and your cabinet. May God bless you. And this cooperation you are showing, please, let it continue. We want unity, we want peace. May God bless you, your family, and all your cabinet. And once again, Mr. Samuel and his son Godwin, thank you for being with us. You see how we worship in Nigeria? This is how we worship. You know, we can go on for another 2 hours. You know, but now we shall stop. You see how the choir, they are very active. There's Mutamata. It doesn't Mutamata Suntashi. Hey, Abuwa. Suntashi. I like Kara's worship. I like to make it a carpet. Oh, she can rush you.
their general meeting come Sunday next week. Sunday, please, here in the parish center. Our Lady of Divine Revelation International Academy, Kwali, the house, their school, sorry, is located behind the police residence. Please, they are calling for admission. They are open. From what they told me, the fees is affordable. It's not costly. Please, we can make use of the opportunity and enroll our children there so that they will do well academically. After the mass, please, the church council and the PPC council will join with, will accompany His Grace Bishop to the parish house where he will have his lunch. May God bless all of us.
And the sisters who are here, is it Immaculate?
And where and who again? Dominicans? And who? Savior, right? In the school or in schools, huh? Okay, well done for your contributions also. God will bless and reward you. Now bow your heads and receive God's blessing. Direct, O Lord, we pray, the hearts of your faithful, and in your kindness grant your servants this grace, that abiding in the love of you and their neighbor, they may fulfill the whole of your commands through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you now and forever.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ. This Mass is ended.